Hello, hope you guys are having an awesome Tuesday. Go ahead and open up Common Lit. Today we're going to take a look at the poem, There's a Certain Slant of Light by Emily Dickinson.
Emily Dickinson's poem, There's a Certain Slant of Light, is woven together in her typical use of ballad meter, in that most of its lines are shorter than usual by one or two syllables. The poem asserts that the light of a winter afternoon is oppressive and heavy, like organ music in a cathedral. It gives heavenly hurt, but leaves no scar, nothing but despair. The afternoon light dominates the landscape, creating shadows when it appears. When it departs at sunset, it becomes unreachably distant, like the look of death. The speaker describes a moment during a New England winter day, focusing on fleeting light that will shortly disappear. In many Dickinson poems, light often brings joy or physical or spiritual illumination, but here it imparts oppressive, painful feelings. On winter afternoons, the light doesn't last long, and its presence is less illuminating than it is in other works. The light, in fact, brings a hint of mortality, for its disappearance is compared with death. In the last stanza, which documents the moment before the light disappears and darkness comes, the landscape and shadows are personified just before they are extinguished in darkness. When the light leaves, Dickinson compares the resulting scene to the unreachability of death on the face of a corpse, the moment of unbecoming so central to many of Dickinson's poems. The light and its removal seems to come from heaven, and although readers may look for meaning, there is none. There's no plan, no lesson to be learned. Meaning, which is internal, is subjective and relative.
All right. Let's go ahead and complete the guided questions. The assessment questions, and I'll have a separate document for the discussion questions. Number one, in the poem, the speaker is significantly affected by the winter light. How have you been emotionally impacted by the seasons? Do you find yourself or people you know sadder or happier during certain seasons? If so, when and why? Number two, in the poem, the speaker uses an extended metaphor and then later personification to discuss elements of nature. How does this contribute to the poem's overall tone and meaning? What are some of the other ways that elements of nature have been generally used in metaphorical ways or given human traits? What purpose have these methods served? Ask students to cite evidence from the text, their own experience, and other literature, art, or history answer. All right, hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and we will see you tomorrow.